Hey Brick fans, this is Dave from Brick 101, and today we have something super awesome. This is an exclusive first look at the upcoming McFarlane Toys Five Nights at Freddy's set, West Hall. They sent us an exclusive prototype of the set. This is a hand-painted prototype to give us a sense of what this set will look like when it comes out in October. This set will contain approximately 145 pieces, retail for about $21, and be a GameStop exclusive in the United States. There's a link in the description where you can pre-order this set from GameStop. And here's a nice handwritten note that was included with the prototype, pointing out that this is hand-painted and that they haven't gotten the clear bricks for this slider yet. So these are gray pieces temporarily just for this prototype, and I had to pull it apart a little bit to get it in there, but it does slide pretty well. So that was a nice note from Evan, who manages all the construction sets for McFarlane Toys. Thanks, Evan. Now this set is a little tricky to get good video and photographs of because it is a hallway and has sidewalls. So if you just kind of look at it from the outside, you see hallway, wall, wall. But you get a little bit of a glimpse down the hallway from this one angle. They have some interesting cutouts here. I'm wondering if that was to kind of increase visibility through so that you could actually see the figures. Otherwise, it would have just been a lot of walls and you wouldn't have been able to see a lot of the action from many angles. The main play feature here is this slide, so you can have Foxy run up and down the hall. That's definitely one of the most memorable moments from the first Five Nights at Freddy's game, is the first time you see Foxy sprinting down the hall towards you. It is terrifying. So this is obviously prototype with hand-painted pieces and not the official part that'll work in there, but it is giving some nice Foxy attack action, even in this version. We've got the white and black tile floor that we're used to. One note is that in this version, at least, there is no attachment point for Bonnie to stand on. I'm not sure if that is going to be in the final version or if this will just be one with no attachment points. We've seen a couple that don't necessarily have attachment points. I believe the backstage did not have an attachment place for Withered Chica, for instance. Some fun details. They've done a great job, as always, with stickers on the wall. Gonna take Foxy off so you can see back there. We've got the all-important Golden Freddy poster on the back corner there, as well as, again, these stickers are hard to show, but some stickers of text documents on that wall, and we've got stars on this wall, as well as some of those normal kind of fun random posters in the back corner there. We've got a doorway, which is nice. Most of the Five Nights at Freddy's 1 sets have a doorway in them, even if they don't have a door piece. So it's nice to have that continuation. You'll also notice this whole set is built one brick up from the ground and has one of those 6 wide connection points. So you could theoretically connect this to a different Five Nights at Freddy's 1 set, like the office here. We'll see they line up at the same height. The brick colors might be a little off here. Again, this one's hand-painted, whereas this one's the official set from 2015. You'll notice the stripe here has red bricks and tiles outlining it, as opposed to black. That is game accurate, even though it seems out of sync with the sets. This west hallway definitely has a red stripe. You can see that in the close-ups near the Golden Freddy poster for sure. So that's an interesting detail. The back there by the Golden Freddy poster, they had a bunch of monitors stuck in the floor there. Kind of obscures the poster, so I took it out just so you could see. These monitors seem to be the same set of monitors that were included with the office. Again, this is a prototype, so not sure if those will be exactly the ones that are included with the final set. Taking a look at the figures, there are 2 figures included in this set. They are new versions of Foxy and Bonnie. Foxy has an eye patch that is up, but otherwise looks pretty much identical to the original Foxy. The feet seem to be the same mold. The hook and hand seem to be the same mold. Colors from the prototype to my Foxy from 2015 vary a little bit, but this is also a hand-painted prototype, so we'll have to wait to the final version to see exactly how the colors match. The only real difference I can see is in the top head mold, with the eye patch being up. The mold itself also seems to be slightly angled up, so that Foxy has an open mouth even when the pieces are pushed together. There is a little bit of room that the top head could be pushed down a little bit, but I don't want to attempt that with a prototype, because these are pretty fragile compared to the normal figures, and I don't want to mess anything up and potentially break the prototype they used to show toy buyers this early version of the set. I think this is a great alternate version of Foxy, being able to have a version of Foxy that is identical to normal Foxy, but just with that eye patch flip, will allow people to animate Foxy's jump scare from the first game, where the eye patch does flip up. So that's a really great detail they've added. Okay, now let's take a look at the new version of Bonnie. What's really exciting to me about this version of Bonnie is that he doesn't have a hole in his chest for a guitar to attach to, so that's great for just having this version of Bonnie out and about, guitar free. You don't have a weird hole sticking out of his chest. So that's really awesome. The other detail that changed is they took the buck teeth off of the top of Bonnie's head. Now, a lot of people had pointed out in the original release that Bonnie doesn't have buck teeth, so it was strange. But now Bonnie has no top teeth, which I think is also a little strange. I feel like there's some middle ground they could have found with some short teeth on the top, because Bonnie does have top teeth. You can see that some of Bonnie's camera footage from the first game, there are some teeth on the top, they're just not very big. Let me know what you think. Do you like Bonnie with buck teeth or Bonnie with no teeth? I'm team buck teeth, actually. I kind of like the first Bonnie look. I might combine the bib from the new Bonnie that has no hole with the original Bonnie with the buck teeth for ultimate Bonnie. Again, I'm not going to do that with the prototype because I don't want to break anything. Many thanks to McFarlane Toys for sending me this exclusive prototype to share with all of the Brick 101 fans out there. This is the only copy of this in the world right now, so I have to send this back to McFarlane Toys so they can use this to show to potential toy buyers around the country. So I'm shipping that back to them right after I finish this video. Let me know in the comments what you think about this set. Do you think this is a good value for the parts? How do you feel about getting new versions of Foxy and Bonnie? This is the first time we've got a set that just has repeated characters with slightly different versions. Do you think it's worth it to get the new versions, or are you going to skip this one and focus on the other classic sets coming out in October? As a reminder, this set is not yet available in stores. Our best estimate right now is October 19th, based on the Amazon pre-orders for the classic sets. And this is going to be only available in GameStops, at least in the United States. And as always, stay tuned for my full review when this set is officially released later this year. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to Brick 101, and check out all my other McFarlane Toys videos.